Hello, and welcome to a presentation of the latest developments in ANSA version 21 in the area of modular RAN management. A couple of years ago, we introduced our intention to systematize the modular management of simulation RANs. In this context, we brought together a new unified environment which covers the analyst needs from the composition of the simulation RAN up to the management of key results and, of course, for all disciplines. Committed to this target, we continuously expand the infrastructure of the modular RAN environment in three main areas. So let's have a look at what was done during this time and is now available with ANSA version 21. First up is the workspace, the front end that assists the users in the bottom-up organization of modular models. In this version, we have redesigned the icons used for parts and all model containers. We introduced a new family of icons with common characteristics such as style, colors, and indicators used across the modular RAN environment. These icons not only represent a more modern approach, improving the look and feel of the tools, but they also make it easier to distinguish and understand its model browser container, improving the overall user experience. With the scope of making our tools much easier and more intuitive, we introduced user toolbars in the model browser and the DM browser. These toolbars come with characteristic icons and clear labeling, providing direct and effortless access to commonly used functionality. The content of the toolbar can be customized with actions from a predefined list, including user-defined actions. A dedicated tool is available for the customization, accessed through the respective option from the toolbar context menu. Toolbars can also be defined per model browser profile, and their settings are saved in the ANSA XML, along with the profile they belong to. Finally, we have collected all the remaining model browser and DM browser functionality in a sandwich menu, offering quick and organized access to the various options. An exciting development in this ANSA version is the introduction of change set management. Our vision behind this was to introduce functionality that could track changes applied on part level, changes regarding the geometry, various engineering data, or changes in the part attributes. This tracking results in the creation of a change set, an ANSA entity that contains all ANSA actions and parameters that were applied on part and subsequently on subsystem level. When the modified part or subsystem is saved in DM, the database infrastructure allows to keep as metadata and associate a change set with a related DM object. In the model browser, a new dedicated to the change set information tab is available. Looking into this tab for parts or subsystems, the user can now easily understand what has changed in the model, track the actions that were applied, and identify the specific parts that were modified through an additional static image that is stored for the subsystem, where the modified parts are highlighted within a transparent module. In the DM browser, a change set associated with a DM object can be seen in the Lifecycle References tab, together with its summary and the characteristic image described previously. To view more detailed information about the associated change set and review the tracked actions, users can now switch to the new change set tab in the DM browser. Another noteworthy change in this version is in the area of the Smart Assembly methodology. Smart Assembly tools were introduced in the past, offering an easy way for the users to mark interface points on the model. However, the NASTRON edit card of those interfaces has been too complex, offering more information than the average user needs when viewing or editing assembly and load case points. In ANSA version 21, we have redesigned the user interface of the edit card for the most commonly used assembly and load case points, offering an equally easy way to view or edit these interfaces. Moving on, let's have a look at what's new in the data storage, the back end of the modular environment that offers storage solutions tailored to CAE needs. An outstanding new development is in the DM browser, which now offers a graphical representation of the lifecycle of a DM object in the form of a pedigree tree. This tree is called the lifecycle graph and is accessed through the respective option in the context menu of DM objects. It displays history relationships, for example, previous and next versions of a subsystem, as well as representation derivations, in other words, the relationship between the ANSA and solver representation of a subsystem. With the use of the lifecycle graph, ANSA now offers a quick and easy overview of a DM object's lifecycle. Still in the DM browser, there is now a dedicated action in the sandwich menu for the direct reloading of the DM views, the DM browser configuration file. This enables users to easily view the result of any adaptation of the configuration file, which controls the DM browser views and the custom actions that can be added in the context menu. This version comes with several improvements in the usability of the DM Schema Editor, the tool offered for the creation of custom data model definitions. Drag and drop functionality has been supported to facilitate the reordering of the properties and attributes during the creation of a custom data model. The notion of protected properties and attributes is now in place for properties and attributes that should not be removed or renamed due to hard-coded constraints in ANSA. Moreover, a check has been added to prevent the creation of duplicate properties and attributes in the data model definition. Finally, a pop-up mechanism has been employed for the display of error and warning messages, messages that have been enhanced and are now substantially more informative. With regards to the data model itself, ANSA now supports the use of aliases for the definition of alternative names for any of the model containers. With the aid of aliases, labels like subsystem, simulation model, or others widely used in the model browser and the DM browser can be renamed into something else that is closer to the terminology used in engineering teams. For example, subsystem could be alias to component, load case could be alias to load case scenario, or report could be alias to key result. The definition of these aliases takes place directly in the DM structure XML, the data model configuration file. Another significant development in the area of the data model is the introduction of the load case header library item. The load case setup assistant, widely used for the definition of load case headers, is now stored in DM as a standalone library item, facilitating the modular management of load cases. These library items, stored either as templates or as ready-to-use libraries, can easily be reused for the creation of multiple load cases. Lastly, in the area of data storage, we have exciting new functionality for those using SPDRM as the main data management backbone. With the introduction of SPDRM in a modular environment, most data management issues, such as data sharing, tracking of changes, or model integrity checks, among others, are addressed. However, once introduced, SPDRM becomes a hard requirement, which means that an always connected status is needed in order to enjoy such benefits. There are cases, though, where this is not always possible or desirable, cases where connection to SPDRM is not reliable, or cases where not all users are allowed to connect to SPDRM. To address these, starting from ANSA version 21, it is possible for DM objects and their dependencies to be checked out into a file-based DM, so that users can work for short periods of time without being connected to SPDRM. This checkout is a high-fidelity copy of the data in SPDRM, meaning that the representation files stored in the file-based DM are the same as the ones stored in SPDRM, with ANSA introducing minimal changes in order to make the files usable. For example, any include references in the main solver files are updated with new paths from the file-based DM. Of course, any attached files are also checked out. It should be noted here that the checkout functionality is currently supported only for Nastran, LSDyna, and PAMCRAS solver files. ANSA version 21 also brings new developments in the methodology and processes of the modular environment, targeted at offering smart solutions for model composition. From now on, all settings that relate to the modular environment are collected under a new group in the ANSA settings window called the modular environment. All settings that relate to save and load parameters, the target model container architecture and file format, as well as the build process, make up a new entity named Modular Environment Profile. In order to accommodate the need for use of different settings for the users in different teams of an organization, modular environment profiles are identified and stored based on two keys, the discipline and the target solver. This way, for example, there can be two profiles for durability discipline, one using Nastran as target solver and one using LSDyna. Another profile can be created for NVH with Nastran and another for safety with LSDyna. Modular environment profiles are stored in file-based DM as new DM objects. When using DM, profiles are version controlled and every change being made in their settings is automatically reflected as a new version in DM. The moment the model container is saved, a reference link is created with a modular environment profile DM object. This way, the modular environment is aware of the exact settings that were used for the creation of data and is able to reuse the same settings automatically on next iteration. For those moments when a connection to DM is not available, modular environment profiles can also be retrieved from the user's beta home folder. A profile can be saved to the beta home folder or at the user-defined location through the respective save options. Moreover, information on the modular environment profile that is active for a user on startup is stored in the user's beta home folder and is updated every time the user saves the ANSA defaults or presses the set as startup profile option. New functionality is now available for the update of compound entities when creating new run iterations. Take as an example the use case where some modifications are performed on one or more of the components of a model and a new version is saved in DM. When the next iteration action is performed for an existing simulation run, it is now possible to replace the contained simulation model or load case with an update from the DM tab of the model browser. The new function will update both the attributes and the hierarchy of the selected compound entity. The only precondition is that the simulation model or load case to be updated are in an unloaded state. The build process of compound model browser containers has also been updated. For simulation models and load cases, the built-in Realize Intermodular Connectors action has been moved to the Load Subsystems build action. As a result, the Realize Intermodular Connectors action became redundant and was removed. Moreover, the Load Subsystems action was renamed to Load Base Modules since it now also loads library items of type Load Case Header and Target Points. Another new feature in the management of the build process is the ability to reorder custom actions using drag and drop operations. It is now possible to drag and drop a script build action or a check build action in between built-in actions in the model browser's build tab in order to customize the build process. In the area of smart assembly, version 21 comes with two new methods for the creation of interface points on the model. It is now possible to select nodes or entities and create assembly or load case points on the center of gravity of the selection. In the edit card that opens, the user can define the required settings and apply them in order to mark the interface points on the model. It is also possible to generate interface points automatically on holes. The user defines the criteria for the identification of the holes, for example the minimum and maximum diameter, and ANSA will automatically mark the interface points on the model, also generating the interface elements specified by the user. This version can also effectively address cases in the model assembly process where the interfaces of various model browser containers are loaded in ANSA but fail to be merged automatically during build due to the distance between them being greater than the default merge tolerance. Users are now able to manually paste pairs of undefined and defined interface points using a new function found in the database browser list of interface points, which assists them in the selection of proper pairs based on the interface point name and the defined status. Moreover, ANSA now facilitates the proper and automatic reattachment of all affected entities when a model browser container that contains interfaces referenced by other containers is loaded in an assembly. Take the use case where a module that contains defined interfaces which are used by entities that do not belong to this subsystem or library item, such as connectors or boundary conditions, is unloaded. This will now trigger the automatic creation of undefined interface points in order to facilitate the proper and automatic reattachment of all affected entities when the container is loaded back in the model. Still in the area of smart assembly, it is now possible to convert an existing set that contains entities from different model browser containers into an assembly set and distribute all generated entities to the proper model browser containers. This is possible through the respective context menu option from the sets list, which generates a domain finder entity that collects the intermodular set contents and places them into the assembly set. Speaking of domain finders, from now on, ANSA supports the definition of simulation models, load cases, and simulation runs as the connectivity of a domain finder. Substantial development was carried out in the area of data storage that now allows marking of subsystems and library items as read-only, in order to indicate that their files should be treated as black boxes during build and save operations. In this way, it is possible to use modules with unsupported keywords or unsupported numbering in the modular environment. The indexing process that extracts the definition attributes of a library item or a subsystem the moment it is added in TM has been enhanced, in order to also extract the real numbering ranges as well as mark the unsupported content. New definition attributes have been added to hold this information as metadata in DM. When a base module with unsupported content is loaded from the DM, it is marked as read-only, which ensures that it will be protected from save both when attempting to save this particular module explicitly and when the saving of this module is triggered automatically from a silent save operation on a higher-level model browser container. Moreover, its definition attributes will always be retrieved from DM, even in cases where the build process is executed while the base module is loaded. ANSA version 21 brings new possibilities for the management of parametrically defined modular models with the support of parameters in the model browser. Saving in DM, parameter definitions are indexed and handled as metadata of the entity that references them. Working on simulation run level, the execution of the build process loads the parameter definitions from DM and their values can be defined. In addition, the new build action named check parameters verifies that all parameters are well defined and that no parameter remains undefined in the main run file. A new information tab is available in the model browser labeled parameters, which lists all the parameters associated with a selected model browser container, as these are retrieved from the definition metadata of the contained modules. Through this list, the user can set the value of undefined parameters and control in which model browser container they will be written out. When the current deck is set to LS-DYNA in particular, ANSA also supports the use of local parameters, parameters defined in base modules. On save, the indexing process described earlier stores the parameter definitions as metadata of the base module in DM. When the build process loads the definition of local parameters, they are treated as locked, and their values cannot be modified. If the modules are added as content of a compound model browser container, such as a simulation model or a load case, the parameters remain locked and it is still not possible to define their values in the compound model browser container. In cases where the full representation of the base module is loaded and the modification of the parameter values is enabled, any changes mark the module as modified through the respective Magenta DM update status. This is an indication that the base module needs to be saved in DM again. Last but not least, we have new development in the generation of reduced subsystem representations. In previous ANSA versions, it was required to work on the full assembly in order to generate the landmass representation of a subsystem used in the model. ANSA version 21 enables working on a standalone, single subsystem with marked interfaces using assembly and load case points. In this case, the landmass generation wizard will properly identify the interface points for the attachment of the rigid elements, leaving the interface points intact. Thank you for your attention, and as always, stay connected.